Christ is risen. Indeed, he is risen. My dear friends, such a special time to the one who really wants to pray, who needs to come to the God of glory, because that person needs the glory of God. And we know that Stephen in chapter 7 of the Acts of Apostles, when he started to witness about resurrected Jesus Christ to the rulers of the temple of that time, and it was like a couple weeks after what's happened in Jerusalem, he said that the God of glory made all that happen. And today, I have like 2 points to mention before starting a new topic. New topic is going to be a continuation. I will continue to read the Acts of Apostles. The first point, if you remember, Jesus first of all went to Samaria. And those people, they didn't know the true God of Israel. And disciples, I think Apostle Peter, he said to Jesus, he said, do to them what Elijah did. Make a fire to come down and burn these cities for what they done. But Jesus said to him, hey, stop. He said, do not do this. Do not forget what kind of spirit you are. Your spirit is to build, to help, to love, to show God's love. And now we see that Philip, the deacon, the first deacon, after the death of Stephen, the first martyr, he went to Samaria. Spirit brought him there, and they were preaching the good news, the gospel about the resurrection of Jesus Christ and about the fulfillment of all the prophecies of Old Testament. And disciples then sent apostle Peter came then. It's like a great teacher. He was number one. He came to pray that the Holy Spirit will abide on them. And you know, just compare, the first point is, some time ago, Peter wanted to burn those cities, and now he is coming to officiate the grace of God to those who had been baptized. Apostle Peter, he had been converted to Jesus. Jesus accepted him, his repentance, and he got a gift of discernment. He was able to see the spirit of the person. It's not an easy task to have that spirit. It's like a liver in the body. The liver is rejecting everything that is not good in blood for the developing of the body, for a production, for a good action. And this is not easy to be a liver. It's not easy to have that spirit of discernment, to see another people. Some people are coming to the temple. Yes, it's so good. They will praise everything. But in their heart, it's a hatred. Apostle Peter saw that. We know that Anani and Sapphira, they dropped dead because they were lying against the Holy Spirit. Against, they were lying to God. Lying to Holy Spirit, it means lying to God. Therefore, Apostle Peter came there later on, after the preaching of the deacon Philip. And they met Simon. There was a Simon, there was a Mag. He was losing his business. He was claiming that he is converted to Jesus Christ. But he wanted to get the grace of God and to do the signs, the miracles. He didn't want to praise the God of glory as Stephen started his preaching. The God of glory did this and that, did everything good. But he wanted the glory of God. He wanted just the signs, the miracles. If this is our aim, if this is why we are coming to the church, it's not good. We have to change. He wanted to buy the grace of God. Simonia, it's a sin to propose money, to do something against the God's grace and to pretend that I am acting like being having the God's grace. He almost died, but he asked disciples, pray for me that nothing of this will happen. They prayed for him, but they stopped that light to the Holy Spirit. We have to remember this. It's so important. We cannot get any position in any ecclesiastical position, any church position, just for our own benefit. It has to be God's benefit. Then we will see the glory of God. Then our community will develop. Chapter 8, verse 26. An angel of the Lord said to Philip, we see how he is being led. The angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to Philip, after what he done this place. He's only a deacon, but the Holy Spirit is abiding in his heart. He has a burning heart, the heart of the Holy Spirit. Get ready and go south to the road that goes from Jerusalem to Gaza. This road is not used nowadays. Therefore, he had been called to go on some road and there is no people. Why to go there? But God has his purpose. Philip got ready and went. Now an Ethiopian eunuch who was an important official in charge of the treasury of the Queen of Ethiopia was on his way home. He had been to Jerusalem to worship God and was going back home in his carriage. And he rode along, as he rode along, he was reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Holy Spirit said to Philip, go over to that carriage and stay close to it. What's happening here? Philip, probably, he was a proselyte to Judaism. He was rich, he had money, he was in power. He supposed not to have any Holy Scripture of Old Testament or prophecies, because even proselytes, they were not entitled to get the Holy Scripture. Those proselytes are those people who are accepting Judaism. But the blood, their blood is not a blood of Abraham. They were still foreigners. But money could do a lot of things. And we could decide it, but maybe he bought that prophecy, that book of prophecy for his money. And he was reading. And Philip ran over and heard his reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. That eunuch was not happy. He was coming back from Jerusalem, from the feast of Passover, but something was disturbing him. He was reading the prophecy and he didn't understand. And this is how terrible it is not to understand what God is addressing to us. He asked him, do you understand what you're reading? The official replied, how can I understand unless someone explains it to me? And he invited Philip to climb up and sit in the carriage with him. The passage of scripture which he was reading was this. It is chapter 53 of the book of Isaiah. He was like a sheep that is taken to be slaughtered. He, it means Jesus Christ, like a lamb that makes no sound. When its wool is cut off, He did not say a word. He was humiliated and justice was denied him. No one will be able to tell about his descendants because his life on earth has come to an end. It was written by Prophet Isaiah 7 centuries before Christ. Life on earth has come to an end, but eternal life, the heavenly life, started after his earthly life. Christ descended into Hades. 3 days later, he resurrected. He was preaching 40 days. He ascended into heaven 40 days after his resurrection. And he will descend the Holy Spirit on the 50th day. And now the Holy Spirit is acting. Philip came to explain this passage of Prophet Isaiah to this important man. This man, as I said, is not happy because he is eunuch. He cannot produce children. He cannot be married. His life is cut on earth. And he doesn't know exactly about eternal life. He doesn't know that there is eternal life. He doesn't know that Christ resurrected and that it was Christ. It was about Christ in Jerusalem that same year and month. Philip, he asked Philip, tell me of whom is the prophet saying this, of himself or someone else? Then Philip began to speak, starting from the passage, from this passage of scripture. He told him the good news about Jesus, the good news about resurrection, the good news that even eunuch's life is not cut off from heavenly kingdom. When he will be baptized, when he will repent in his sins, his eternal life is just starting. He will be saved when he will come to resurrected Jesus. This is the greatest joy to everyone. If you have even one talent, this talent will give you eternal joy. That talent is our life, and desire to serve Christ will save us. As they traveled down to the road, they came to a place where there was some water, and the official said, here is some water. What is to keep me from being baptized? He wants to live eternal life. He found explanation of his life and of the purpose. Well, why he was proselyte? Why did he get that piece of Holy Scripture? Probably he bought it, as I said. Even he was not entitled to have it because they were hiding the kingdom of God, the Pharisees and Sadducees, particularly after Jesus' resurrection, because they didn't believe in Jesus' resurrection, because they were losing business. They didn't want people to worship alive, God who is alive, who resurrected. They wanted still to keep them and to bring more and more lambs to buy them and to do all 10 feasts of Old Testament and to pay for those feasts. But Jesus came and he said that he is that life, that he is that light and life, everything. He said, I am this, because my Father just was leading you to me. And this has happened, is happening here to this official. He wants to be baptized, he wants to be saved. The official ordered the carriage to stop, and both Philip and the official went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord took Philip away. We see how the Holy Spirit is acting. He took him away. Why? Because there is many other things to do. There is many other places to preach and to witness resurrected Jesus. The official did not see him again, but continued on his way full of joy. Again, I said yesterday, the word joy, English word, J-O-Y. It's like Jesus, others, and you. He was living, you, others, and Jesus, probably he didn't know him, but now he knows him through baptism and repentance, and his life turned around. Jesus first, others, and then himself. And his joy is to serve Jesus, resurrected Jesus, by helping others. Philip found himself in Azotus. He went on to Caesarea, and on the way, he preached the good news in every town. Absolutely, that is his devotion, to preach the good news. And all the disciples will preach the good news about Jesus Christ, resurrected one. And this is, my dear brothers and sisters, my friends, is our task. It should be our devotion to preach the good news, to live according to the gospel. And that eternal joy will always be with us. Amen. Christ is risen. Indeed, he is risen.